Now we will see module 4, aerial photogrammetry. Photogrammetric survey is a science and art of obtaining accurate measurement by use of photographs for various purposes such as construction of topographic maps, classification of soil, interpretation of geology, acoustics of military, intelligence and preparation of composite pictures on the ground. Photogrammetry is nothing but it is an art of obtaining some measurements using the photograph. Using the photograph, we will get some measurement. It is nothing but photogrammetry. This is used in some geological work, maps and soil classification. Even in military also, they will use the photogrammetry technique. The photographs are either taken from the air or from station on the ground. Photogrammetry is nothing but here photographs are taken. The photographs that are taken may be from the air or from the ground. The photogrammetry surveying is classified into two types. This photogrammetry, the main thing is photogrammetry, that is classified into two types. One is terrestrial photogrammetry and another one is aerial photogrammetry. By just reading the names, we will get to know this is terrestrial, maybe from the land, and this is aerial. Photographs are taken from the above, like some with some height. Now we will see in depth what is terrestrial photogrammetry and what is aerial photogrammetry. First one, terrestrial photogrammetry. It is a branch of photogrammetry where in photographs are taken from fixed position or near the ground. See, as I said here, photographs are taken from the ground, somewhere fixed in the ground. Second one, aerial photogrammetry. In this branch of photogrammetry, when the photographs are taken by a camera mounted in the aircraft flying over the area. Here in this type, the photographs are taken by the camera which is mounted to the aircraft which is flying with some definite height. Mapping from aerial photographs is the best mapping procedure for large projects and are invaluable for military intelligence. If the areas are too vast, doing normal survey in those areas is too difficult. So, in the areas of with large project, this method is best suited. The major use of aerial mapping method, the civilians and military mapping agencies of the government. The major using of aerial mapping is done by military mapping and some agencies of the government, they use the aerial photogrammetry. For us, in this module, we are only deal with aerial photogrammetry. Now we will see uses and application of photogrammetry. What are the application or uses of photogrammetry? First one is geologic mapping. Geologic mapping. It involves identification of landform, rock types and rock structures, folds, faults and fracture. Using photogrammetry, we can identify the rock types and structure. Second one, soil mapping. It involves detailed soil survey. Using photogrammetry, we can even do the soil survey. Land use and land cover mapping. It is done to display the uses of land selected for human activities such as dissipation of lakes, trees, glacial and ice. By using the photogrammetry, by doing the survey for some area of the land, we can see, okay, this much area of the land can be selected for human activities and other areas are consist of lakes, rivers. We can differentiate the concept or things which are there in the area. Next is agricultural application. This photogrammetry has its application in agriculture field also. It involves crop condition assessment, crop yield estimation, and area of crop type classification. These are all the activities which we can do by using photogrammetry in the field of agriculture. Next is forestry application. It involves the identification of tree species, timber movements, and assessment of disease and insect infections. Using photogrammetry in the area of forestry, we can identify the tree species and assessment of any disease or insect infections. Next application is in the sector of water resource application. It can be used in variety of ways to help to monitor the quality, quantity, and geographic distribution of water. The detection of water pollution, estimation of flood damage, groundwater location. Using the photogrammetry, we can calculate the quality and quantity of the water, the pollution content and any damages made by the flood, and also the groundwater potential or groundwater location. Next application is urban and regional planning application. It is useful in population estimation, housing quality, quantity studies, parking studies, site selection process, route location. Using photogrammetry, the population estimation could be done. Densely populated area, in that area, what is the quality or quantity of the homes which are situated, and parking studies, and best route. We can select the best route by using photogrammetry. Next application is wildlife ecology application. It involves wildlife habitat mapping, wildlife senses. Using the photogrammetry, we can map the wildlife senses and their habitat. By keeping the cameras at some place in the forestry, we can do this kind of survey. Another application is archaeological application. It is used to analyze the remains of historic and prehistoric human aquities. Using the photogrammetry, we can do the analysis in archaeological department, that is of historic and prehistoric survey. Environmental assessment. The adverse environmental effect of the human activities can be assessed. By using the photogrammetry, we can do the survey of environmental effect made by human activities. And next is GIS. We already studied what is GIS, GPS, remote sensing. This plays a greater role in preparation of topographic maps. In photogrammetry, in aerial photogrammetry, we will take the photograph. By getting the images from there, we have to prepare the map. And this GIS plays a very important role in that. For the purpose of aerial photogrammetry, we need aerial camera. Next, we will see what is that aerial camera.
Aerial cameras, how it will figures will be applied. See here, in this cases, this is aerial camera. Okay, in this cases, first one is magazine, second one is, see here, first one is magazine, second one is focal plane, and third is body, fourth is the trunnion axis, see here. Fourth one is, this is a trunnion axis. You people study in theodolite, trunnion axis. And fifth one is cone. This is cone. And sixth one is lens. See here, this is a lens, camera lens is. And seventh one is, wait, see, seventh one is shutter. When we people will having a uses, no, then it will open, after that it will shuttering. Eighth one is diaphragm. And fourth, last one is filter. So image will be filter and it will comes. Okay, see here. So aerial photographs consist of some parts. So already I explained that cone, plane, body, okay, only I told name. And lens assembly, how lens will be assembly? See here, it consists of a lens diaphragm, the shutter and the filter. In the lenses cases, lens case it will comes, see here, in these cases, so lens will comes. So in these cases filter will be appear. So see here, in this object plane, so once we will seeing by the lens, and lens will be captured the image, it will be refracted in A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash, E dash way. Okay, and by using a from starting point to in C figure, starting it is a observer, and dash is get the images, will get the images, and N is lens. Okay, see here, already they mention N and N dash as front nodal and rear nodal point, and F is the focal length. Focal length from the lens to image. And so I will explain one by one. The shutter. So in shutter, what will happens and what will do work shutter? So the camera shutter controls the interval of a time during which light is allowed to passes through the lens. When light is allowed to passes through the lens, during that time it is controls the interval of time. Okay, the diaphragm. Next one is diaphragm. So in this diaphragm, what will happen? It is a place between the lens elements. It consists of a series of a leaves which can be rotated to increase or decreases the size of opening to restrict the size of bundle of a rays passes through the lenses. Okay, in the next one is the filter. So what will happen in filter? It is consist of a pieces of a color glasses placed in the front of the lens. It filters the stray light in the atmosphere caused by the moisture. It is also protect the lens from the flying particles in atmosphere. Okay, camera cone. I told it is a slant, no, so that is camera cone. In that camera cone, the camera cone supports the entire lens assembly, including the filter at the top of it, are provided collimation marks. See here, so fifth one is camera cone. Okay, and focal plane is second one. See, focal plane, the collimation marks are provided at the upper surface of the cone. The focal plane is provided exactly above the collimation marks. So this will happens in focal plane. and camera body. Where it is camera body? Third one. See here, camera body. Camera body is the part of the camera provided at the top of the cone. So this is the cone. No, it is provided at the top of the cone. And drive mechanism. In this case is drive mechanism. So how it will drive the picture and how it will, by using of drive mechanism, we will get the picture. It is house the camera body, okay, and is used for, first one is it will used for winding and tripping the shutter and winding the film. It may be operated mechanically or manually. And next is magazine. See here, where it is magazine. It holds the exposed and unexposed forms and houses the film floating devices at the focal plane.